I'm sure you have noticed that by default in your slicers the extrusion width is always set to wider than the actual nozzle size. But what happens if we put it to a lower value? In the past I got pretty good results this way, so I was down to see if they would remain the same, but this time using way faster modern 3D printers. This video is all about possible slicer hacks to get more details in your prints without reducing the physical nozzle size. We will test various settings and nozzles and see how that affects the details, layer consistency and layer adhesion of our prints. So, can you print with a 0.4 nozzle as detailed as with a 0.21? Well, let's find out. I started with testing a 0.5mm nozzle and printing the outer wall at 0.2mm width at 165mm/s speed. I made two different types of prints. The first one will show if we are actually getting increased details, and the second one how consistently the outer walls of the prints look. Checking the details, they were better than using the narrow extrusion, but nothing to go crazy about. Looking at the comparison pictures from the past testing, I can also confirm that. It won't be as good as an actual 0.4mm nozzle, but there still will be an improvement in the details. The only question is how this will affect the look of the outer layers of the print. I couldn't spot anything in the z-axis direction, but looking at the xy axis, the print surface had a slightly rippling pattern and looked less consistent. The only exception was when printing fiber-filled filaments. Tim Murray sent several spools to test their glass-filled PTG, and I have to say that I actually prefer the bigger nozzle and the narrow extrusion results. It makes the pattern of the prints way more pronounced. To fully test this scenario and their filaments, I printed one of my more complex projects. The reasons why I prefer glass fiber filled filaments for such builds are because even larger prints have basically zero warping and parts are way more rigid. This makes the assembly process a dream, as every part has a proper dimensional accuracy. Looking closer at the prints when using the narrow extrusion, for the most part everything looked great. The only small defects I could spot were above the overhangs. These are common with round holes if cooling is not sufficient, and the over defects were caused by too high difference in printing speeds. For some reason, Orca Slicer sometimes treats these sections as overhangs and not bridges. Thanks to Gregoire for pointing in the right direction. Going back to printing regular PLA with narrower extrusion, I was wondering how this affects the layer adhesion strength. To test that, as always, I use my custom test print, where the middle section is printed at increasing speeds, then cut and break samples on a tensile strength testing machine. As each data point consists of 20 samples, it takes a while to test them. So, to improve my experience when using the machine and filming for a video, I designed an integrated lighting solution. It uses a high-efficiency passively cooled heatsink design that was 3D printed from aluminum using today's video sponsor PCBWay Manufacturing Services. Unlike CNC machining, 3D printing from metal leaves a grainy texture on the prints. This means it might require some post-processing. In this case, I had to sand flush the spot where the MCPCB of LEDs will be mounted and make the threads for the screws. The design uses parts for a flashlight, and the final look is a beautifully diffused high CRI lighting with a simple and convenient control. With all that done, I compared the narrow extrusion to the previous layer adhesion results of the Raptor 2 hotend. Printing 0.4mm walls with a 0.5mm nozzle yielded quite noticeably worse strength results that significantly dropped off at higher printing speeds. Just for the laughs, I also tried printing at 0.22 wall width with the same 0.5mm nozzle, and while the test print had a very cool and unique texture, it basically had no strength. These results indicated that I have to print more slowly. So I tried printing the outer wall with a narrow extrusion at 50 and 75mm/s speeds. I took a blind test and it was pretty easy to spot the best looking extrusion. Printing just slightly above the nozzle's diameter resulted in the cleanest looking surface following the 50mm/s print with a narrower extrusion. But what about a regular 0.4mm nozzle? With this one I really wanted to try pushing it to the under limit to see if we can get details that are close to a 0.2mm nozzle. At first I used the matte type of PLA and the results when using narrow extrusion were quite literally atrocious. However, the more details she print turned out way better. But to be fair, I also had to slightly lower the layer height for the narrow extrusion to work. While it doesn't get to a 0.2mm nozzle details, The fact that this was done with a 0.4mm nozzle and just by playing with a few slicer settings made me optimistic to continue my tests. To give my best try, I switched to a better flowing Sunlumeta PLA that I was using back in the day that provided good results. First, I tried printing at a regular 0.42 and narrow 0.32mm outer wall widths at 125mm/s speed. Both prints looked quite similar, even the details, so I decided to go all in and try to make the 0.22mm extrusion to work with a 0.4mm nozzle. I won't bother you with all the prints that didn't work out, but rather talk about what actually worked. First of all, you must reduce the lay height to half of the extrusion width. Then you have to slow down the outer wall by a lot to make sure that the filament is properly heated and flowing very well. Reducing the outer wall acceleration and pressure advance value is also recommended. But even then, I couldn't fully eliminate those small defects in the prints where we have smooth continuous surfaces. However, some models print extremely well using these settings. It works wonders on prints that have fully textured surfaces and insane amount of detail. The fact that we can squeeze so much depth from a 0.4 nozzle without changing to a smaller one is truly amazing. The same principles also work with a bigger 0.5mm nozzle. This model was scaled to 150% and again you can see how much more detailed the print looks using the 0.32mm extrusion width. On detailed models like these, the outer walls look consistent because we are limited by the printer's cornering velocity and we're never reaching higher speeds. But when we encounter prints that have smooth surfaces, you have to slow down the outer wall to crawling speed like on old 3D printers of 25mm/s to get it to work. Anything above will significantly affect the extrusion consistency and lay adhesion. But despite this huge slowdown of the outer wall, the printing times are still not higher compared to the smaller nozzles with default profiles, because here we print inner walls at the regular wider setting. So while it is not recommended to print narrower than the nozzle's diameter for the most consistent print surfaces, dimensional accuracy and strength, by tweaking a couple of slicer settings, you can easily squeeze way more detail into your prints, even with bigger nozzles. Hopefully this was an interesting topic. What are your thoughts about all this? Do you think it is stupid or is it actually a viable option when you are too lazy to change the nozzle? Feel free to leave a comment below. Huge thanks to all the Patreon and YouTube members for your continued support. Well, that's all from me and I'll see you next time.